Hey, we're Miss Mister.
And you're watching Made in the District.
Monday is January.
You guys are on tour for How Does It Feel? This is one of our favorite venues in the entire country to play. I think we played every tour we've ever been on. So opening for many of the first shows, and then we headlined our own show here on the end of the last campaign. And so it feels nice to start the How Does It Feel tour, kicking off here.
How is the vibe different with this album from the last album? What did you guys want to change, like, to show your fans, like, to give to your fans?
This album's way more dancey. It's all about movement. When we were touring the first record, we realized how much movement was important to us and how we are real dancers at heart. And we wanted that to come across more in the music and make music that was more sort of focused and hard-hitting. And, not music that you could dance to, but music that made you dance. So that was definitely our goal with this record.
So you guys have definitely been to DC before, 930 U Street Music Hall as well. Well, have you guys ever gotten to, like, explore around? If so, like, what's your favorite spot?
Well, my dad is actually born and raised in D.C.
Oh, really?
And one of my best friends at home is in D.C. So I spent a lot of time here growing up, mostly around the Chevy Chase Garrison Street area. And then when we're here, we usually just go up to bars all around. Yeah. But 930 is our D.C. home, I guess.
So we see this do-it-yourself stuff. So do you guys do this a lot on tour, or like you guys are like crafty? You guys don't really go expensive and all that.
No. We're super crafty. We do a lot of vintage shopping on the road. That's what our group likes to do. And actually, go and visit. It's a nice way to sort of get a different perspective of the land. And then you look at your closet after tour, and you're like, oh, I remember all the places I've been. I got this in Texas. I got this in Nashville. So that's cool.
But yeah, definitely about DIY. It's really fun to also take a vintage piece or a play piece from Ace House Racing or wherever, and then, really make your own, making something completely new that no one else has. So, thank you, Chris, it falls apart in two shifts.
What can we expect from you guys in the future, like future collabs, or like, who would you guys want to collab with in the future?
I don't know who we would collaborate with in the future. There's something sort of, nice and unique. I think for us that we've done two albums with no collaborations or features, I think that's becoming more and more odd and unheard of in this sort of musical landscape. But I would like to do a duet with someone in the future. I don't know who that person would be. It would be cool to sing a song with Mac DeMarco, although I would take it way more seriously than she would. I don't know who you want to collaborate with.
LCD sound system would be amazing.
Okay, last question. What's a hashtag that would describe your sound?
Hashtag
bombastic.
Bombastic.
Yeah.
Not too sick. And then the flash.
Flash
emoji.
As a
blue
ball.
No, you had a whisker, so it's like,
yeah.
We try and evade our heartless cage. This is no alarm for distress.